Welcome to Fort Hill United Methodist Church. You are in for a treat. Today's music will lift up your spirits, challenge your concept of joy, and give you an opportunity to be so filled with the Spirit that you're just going to reach back into that pocket and show your gratitude. But this is not just an opportunity for you to come and just take it in. There are parts of this worship service where you are going to participate. Music and worship is a participant's activity. And all of us are called by God and one another to join in the celebration. So there are four opportunities in this service. And one of them is going to begin just a moment. On the fifth verse of For Everyone Born, the congregation is asked to turn to their insert and join in singing that fifth verse.
And the refrain every time.
And the refrain every time. Thank you. Then there are two hymns there later on in the service, Leaning on the Everlasting Arms and Victory in Jesus. That's for everyone's participation, all of it. And at the close of the service, in a true air and spirit of celebration, we will lift high the cross with our hearts and voices when we come to the close of that presentation and all of us join together in singing those immortal and fantastic declaration words of great joy and victory. So, be prepared to participate, be prepared to be grateful, and now sit back and be blessed.
Young and for old, the right to belong. Just a place at the table, a place around it. Thank you all for coming to support Parkview Community Mission today. My name is Gordy Harper, and I'm the Executive Director of Parkview. At Parkview Community Mission, we have chosen to love God and to love people. I've been given the privilege of leading a group of amazing people and serving a group of amazing neighbors. We are known for the 1 million pounds of food we receive and distribute to those in need in our community. That food has been used as a catalyst to build relationships and to show the love of Christ to our neighbors we serve here in Central Virginia. Our goal is to not be thought of so much for the food, but for the life transformation that begins with our Food for Families food pantry, where our food insecure neighbors are able to choose their own food. Through our Community Resource Center, where neighbors are guided through a process of discovering resources that can restore hope in their lives. Through the Parkview Cafe, where they are served a hot meal in a loving and caring atmosphere. Our Food for Thought program, where school children who receive free meals during the week at school are given food to take home for the weekends. And our Life Skills Institute, where neighbors are guided through classes in personal finance, interviewing skills, basic computing, reading comprehension, and other classes that will give them help, healing, and hope. Your support makes this all possible. Our programs are growing and need support. What we need is ongoing support. Thank you to Janet for pulling this together and to all the participants who have come to share their gifts so that Parkview Community Mission can continue to work towards life transformation for our less fortunate neighbors here in Central Virginia.
Hi, my name is Rachel Koenig, and I'm the Associate Director at Parkview Community Mission, as well as the Director of the Food for Families program. Oops. As Gordy had just mentioned, he shared with you a little bit about the different programs that are offered at Parkview. But one thing that we've come to learn and really implement is just this practice of relationships, like Gordy mentioned. We understand that no number of programs or resources is what is going to transform someone's life, but it is about relationships and love. And I was so encouraged as we sang that first song, where it just talks about there's a place at the table for everyone, for man and woman, young and old, and I would add to that rich and poor. I think we are all stewards of the relationships in our lives, and we've learned what power there is in breaking down barriers and just allowing the love of God to flood through Parkview and the community. And it's been incredible to see the power of these resources that we are able to use as tools, and then the love of God that we've just allowed to guide us. Just a quick little story I wanted to share with you to show how some of those programs and the relationships have impacted lives. We had a young man, he had three little boys. He was living in a town, in a county actually, probably about 40 minutes away. And his wife had left him with three little boys, 4, 5, and 6. And all of a sudden he was on his own, just, you know, left by himself to care for these little ones. And we were able to help him, provide food for him for a couple weeks until he was staying at Salvation Army, and he was able to eventually get in touch with social services through our Community Resource Center, where they connected him with child care and employment, and he now has his own house. His kids are enrolled in school, and he's getting back on his feet. But we just see that over and over again, stories like that. And one thing we've also been encouraged by lately is we have people that come on by to Parkview, not just for our resources, but we find they come just to say hello, just to be in community and spend time with us. And it is just incredibly powerful to see what the love of Christ can do. So as Gordy mentioned, we can use your help financially, but more than that, we would love for you all to see your faces. I see a lot of familiar faces. I know a lot of you have served at Parkview before. So we invite even more of you to come alongside us and experience the love of Christ at Parkview. Thank you.
My name is Susie Poindexter, and I am one-third of the Beacon of Light trio. One other third of the trio, the one that I'm married to, Bobby Poindexter, is sick with a sinus infection and couldn't be here today. So I hope you will allow me to fill in as a substitute for the Beacon of Light and sing for you a song written by Heather Sorensen. It's a song that for all people, all Easter people, it's a reminder that we all have a place and we all belong home in the arms of God. Every heart without a home, every widow left alone, every soul that is distressed, there is rest. Every prayer that has no voice, or the freedom to rejoice, from the darkness be released, there is peace. There is peace. There is rest. There is hope for the broken. There is help for the weak. There is peace. There is rest. And the arms of God will hold you all the way. Every sinner who's confessed, but in guilt is still oppressed by the sin that's been erased, there is grace. When the Father walked away and the mother's left to pray, when the child has been disowned, welcome home. Welcome home.
Welcome home.
Good evening, everyone. What beautiful music. I am so blessed to be here today, and I am so grateful for all that you do. My name is Lisa Stump, and I am the Parkview Community Center volunteer director. And I come here today with a humble heart because you guys are the movers and the shakers. And I'm often blessed just by being in the presence of you guys. With that said, the summer is quickly approaching us, and a lot of the students will be going back home, and they will not be here with us. So I am here requesting some hands and feet to come and help us out. Our business hours are from roughly 9 o'clock until 4 or 5, depending on the task at hand. The days are Wednesdays, Thursdays, and Saturdays that we're looking for people to come and help us. We have various opportunities for you. On Wednesdays, we set up and we prepare for the serving of the neighbors on Thursdays and Saturdays. With that said, I would like to cultivate many people to, you know, be on call to be able to help us unload trucks, stock, clean, input data in the computers, weigh the food when it comes in. This is a big project. Parkview is just really growing in leaps and bounds. Ever since I started working there, I've been running ever since. And it's a good thing. It's a lot of good things happening and a lot of people being blessed. Charles Swindoll said one time, "We are never more than God is when we give." I've been doing this type of community service and for a long time. And just to hear the neighbors come out and say how blessed they are, which they really are, they're truly grateful for what you do. I'm never wondering if we're going to have enough volunteers, because the Lord blesses us every time we're there. When I see you come through the doors or making a donation or bringing me those bags, garbage bags, plastic bags, I love them because we use them a lot for clothing and putting produce in them, and a lot of various other things like the Panera bread. So get your group together and bring me those grocery bags. We use them quite often. That's a big thing, folks. But with that said, I am here, and I would love to hang in the back later after the concert to speak to you guys. I want to get to know you personally, because I know each and every one of you here have special talents and skills and gifts, and I would love to be able to plug you in. I am part-time right now with Parkview, and I'm looking to go on full-time after completing school in August. And with that said, it's going to be so many more opportunities for us. And in the meantime, you can also go on our internet and sign up. But like I said, I would love for you to give me a call as well to let me know, so we can work together and get a lot of things done. But I'm so grateful for you, and I thank you for all that you do. And I got my little pad here, so I would love to take home some names with me. And it's fun. It's not only just volunteering, guys. You get to pour in the lives of a lot of the neighbors here that are truly hurting and needing, you know, someone just to come and say, "I love you," or "How are you today?" It is so much more than greeting them. and giving them a bag of food. It is so much more than that. And each day, like I say, that I'm with Parkview, I am truly blessed to be a part of something just as grand as what we do down there. We have a lot of fun. We're looking for those truck drivers. We are looking for those computer people that's good and in putting information in the computers. We have people that come in as early as 8 a.m. in the morning. So we need people to greet them and give them coffee and to just you know, talk with them. I bet it's so many of them don't have healthy relationships with anyone. And sometimes it's often us just to come and to speak with them and to share with them. But with that said, please do come and speak with me. That's why I'm here today, and just to share your talents and gifts with me. And it might be something you can help me with, who knows? But I know the Lord gives us all gifts and talents, and I know we have them here. So I'm grateful for you. And with that said, I think we have a video next, so let's just pay attention to that. Glory sighting.
Well, for me, a glory sighting is an experience that doesn't happen just day to day.
The whole facility is Parkview Community Mission, which contains 12 different ministries. The Food for Families, or the Food Pantry, is by far the largest and has been here for over 10 years. The community looks at Parkview as a very safe place to be.
The goal of the pantry is to meet the needs of our food insecure neighbors. Stuff happens all week. Our main days are Wednesdays, Thursdays, and Saturdays. The client choice model allows people to go through and shop for themselves. But if the world could see the people come through here, there's up to 24 items available in our USDA room, just that one room. And I've seen people get one thing. And the reality is they'll tell me, I don't get what I don't need. Other people need it more than I do.
We only have two part-time people. The rest of it is volunteers. And we actually have almost 400 volunteers a month putting in over 1,300 hours. We can't operate without volunteers.
We've been blessed with many volunteers of the students, and that has been kind of a highlight to me, to reach into the students' lives and to see the transformation.
Hey, Brenda.
And to see their lives turn to service. And they're already come in and they have tender hearts to people. And it's been powerful to me to see the young people just kind of embrace this service and with servant hearts.
The people come on a first come, first served basis. So some of them get here 4 and 5 hours ahead of time. So as the people are here, we're trying to figure out how we can best minister to them and provide services, talk to them, create relationships.
So by pulling down the walls, we get to embrace their lives. And then we start to understand who they are. What are their needs? I mean, the food is a catalyst for this whole thing, that where we can start to enter into their lives and love on them, show them the love of Christ, and then try to figure out what do they need to come from where they are. We're starting to bring into Food for Families and Parkview Community Mission things that can actually start to build their lives and help their lives go forward.
I guess our dream is to develop the model for the new Methodist Church, to have what will appeal to the young people and what will help get people back in touch with God and how they can use their talents to benefit others.
I just would like for the world to understand that these are precious people going through difficult circumstances, and this pantry is here for you and me as well. I just am blessed to not have to need it right now. But if I do, I'm coming. And I just honor them for being able to come to this place in their life where they're willing to walk through that door and like at this time in their life and get what they need. And I just thank God we're able here to provide it.
thanks for the things you have done for me. Things so undeserved, yet you gave to prove your love for me. The voices of a million angels could not express my gratitude. All that I am and ever hope to be, I owe it all to thee. To God
comes your opportunity to perform, to become part of a ministry that is larger than ourselves, a ministry that puts those who can't give more than gratitude back, but benefit from. So at this time, be prepared to give so that others may be blessed, and may God bless us all in the process.
God's almighty hand. He sends the snow in winter, the warmth to swell the grain, the breezes and the sunshine, and soft refreshing rain. Oh,
Oh,
Lift up mine eyes unto the hills, whence cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord, the Lord which made heaven and earth. He said, thee will not suffer thy foot to be moved. The Lord that keepeth me, he will not slumber nor sleep. Oh, the Lord is thy keeper, the Lord is thy shade. Upon thy right hand, upon thy right hand, no, the sun shall not smite thee by day, nor the moon by night. He shall preserve thy soul, even forevermore. My help, my help, my help, all of my help cometh from the cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord, the Lord which made heaven and earth. He said, he will not suffer thy foot to be moved. The Lord that
help. Friends, my name is Scott Davis. I am fortunate and blessed to have my office at the Parkview Community Mission Center. I'm down at the Burger King end, and I have a corner office. And I want to say, first of all, thank you, Janet Hawkins, and your design team. Where is Janet? Janet's on the move, like, all the time. So thank you for calling out all of these gifts to come together. What a tremendous afternoon it has been. We know when people of faith get together and we take some risks to step out of our comfort zones, whether we're serving or worshiping, that God can use that and do some great things with that. So I so much appreciate the spirit in which we've gathered today. And I don't get to announce the totals for fundraising efforts very much in my current role, but I am pleased to have that opportunity today. I would like to share with you the good news that this afternoon we have raised $1,456.50 for the Parkview Community Mission Center. And let us go to God in prayer as we give thanks for these gifts. Loving God, I thank you that from the very beginning of creation, you are a God who gives. It is in your very nature to always be thinking about your creation. And we thank you that we see the pattern of your giving, the outpouring of your love in your Son, Jesus Christ, who came not to serve but to serve and spent his life mainly among those who are on the margins of his society. And he calls us to that same example of love. And so thank you, Lord, that today we've gathered here to help bless the work of Parkview Community Mission Center. I thank you for the many and diverse lives who find an intersection there at Parkview, whether they are volunteers or neighbors or whether they are supporters. So thank you that these gifts are going to make a difference in the lives of so many of our neighbors. And so bless our efforts today. Continue to show us how to love and how to give. And I pray this in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, who is alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. And all God's people here said, Amen.